aw ala safarin. Safarin ka matlab koi safar, ek safar koi safar. Isme bhi waqt, dauraniya, faasla kuch nahi bataya gaya. Jab wo shakhs ye assume kar raha hai ki main halat e safar ki mushaqqaton mein roza nahi rakh sakta, to it is between he and his Allah as it is. Safar ke hawale se wo ahadees e mubarakah maujood hain. Hazrat Aisha رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ farmati hain ki Hazrat Hamza bin Amr Aslami ye bahut zyada kasrat se roze rakhte the aur Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke sath ek safar mein the, to unhone sawal kiya, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, kya main safar mein roza rakhun ya chhodun? To aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ne farmaya, chahe to rakhe to chahe to chhod. Aapne dono options de di. Isi tarah Hazrat Abu Sa'id Khudri رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ ki riwayat se Muslim mein hadith aati hai ki Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke sath hum jihad ke safar par nikle, kisi ghazwe ka jihad ka safar tha, aur aksar riwayat mein ghazwa Badr hi ke wale se hai. Aur kuch logon ne roza rakha aur kuch ne nahi rakha. Aur aap bhi farmate hain ki jin logon ne rakha tha, aapne unko ye nahi kaha tumne kyon rakha, aur jinhone nahi rakha tha aapne unse ye nahi pucha tumne kyon nahi rakha. So there is an open option, you want to you may, and if you don't want to you may not. Lekin ek aur hadith yaad rakh lijiye, aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ne farmaya, safar mein iftar roze se behtar hai. Jaise namaz e qasr ke liye bhi hadith ke alfaz aate hain na ki qasr ke naam hai, isko qabool kar lo. To isi tarah safar mein iftar roze se behtar hai. Zahir hai safar ki halat mein wo ibadat, wo khushu, wo khuzu, wo sari concentration mumkin nahi hogi. To isliye option de di gayi ki isko chhod do, lekin baharhal kuch logon ke liye baad mein mokhar karke postpone karke rakhna zyada mushkil hai. To isliye Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ne practically dono ki ijazat de di, lekin na rakhne ko pasand farma liya.